afternoon and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. The Kangana Ranaut interview has created a storm. When I did the interview, I had a sense that she would get a lot of support, but I must say at the start that, you know, we've been completely overwhelmed with the kind of nationwide support that has built for what Kangana has said. And there is a cabal which is hurting, which is stunned. I was asked this morning, what is the kind of feedback we've had to the interview? I said, there are only people in support of Kangana. And the other side has gone completely silent. And there are fundamental reasons why they've gone completely silent. The group that I call the Bollywood Mafia, the Bollywood Lobby, they've gone completely silent, A, because Kangana is completely correct. Secondly, they've gone silent because they know deep in their hearts that one of the reasons for Sushant Singh Rajput's unfortunate demise is the role of the Bollywood Lobby. Thirdly, they can't meet themselves in the eye. The fourth reason is because Kangana was speaking for a lot of us, And I know that today there are a lot of people who would like to speak in support of Kangana, but who don't have her guts, who are not willing to come out and take a stand just yet. But I believe that things are changing. Ladies and gentlemen, at the start of the Sunday debate, let me say this. We are not discussing the existence of the Bollywood Lobby. I think a more appropriate word to describe them would be mafia. Because they serve in self-interest, they break rules, they carry out illegalities in stealth, and Kangana has been unsparing about them. What did Kangana talk about? From claims about a Bollywood mafia to those she called as a quote-unquote suicide gang. From questioning a cabal of sellout journalists, I wouldn't call them journalists, I would call them third-grade PR artists, who are at the beck and call of a certain circuit in Bollywood, to speaking up on the systematic ouster of those who don't come from rich and powerful families and rich and powerful camps. She spoke for a lot of us. From questioning the investigation, the sham investigation being carried out so far by the Mumbai police on Sushant Singh Rajput's suicide, to even saying that she's willing to give up her Padma Shri. If anything she says is proven to be false. Kangana has opened up a can of worms. A Bollywood lobby that no one spoke against is seeing voices speak up now and speak up openly. One by one, they are all beginning to speak. And it is not just about one actor. It is not just about one issue. The rot, if you analyze it, it seems runs much deeper. The malaise is much worse. And the danger, if everything that is said is to be believed, is looming for all those who come to Mumbai with limited dreams. Limited means, but big dreams and truckloads of talent. So on this Sunday debate, my focus is on the Bollywood lobby. And I'd like to just put out a very broad question to start with as I introduce the panel. Has this Bollywood lobby, which can also be more appropriately described as a self-serving mafia, killed talent? Has it used positions to subvert, subjugate people who don't come from their circuit? Has this Bollywood lobby been exposed with the words and treatment that it has meted out to talented outsiders? Should the Bollywood lobby now face serious investigation for Sushant's suicide? Is there a bootlicking PR machinery group that has tried to control the media via the message on behalf of the Bollywood lobby? And is the Bollywood lobby squirming this afternoon? Ladies and gentlemen, those who say there is no Bollywood lobby, shockingly so they say that. Mayank Shekhar, film critic and author Sameer Soni, Bharti Pradhan on your screen, no Bollywood lobby. They say we are making this all up. Everything's fine, hunky-dory. Everything's going to be fine. I can tell you one thing about them. They've been consoling themselves over the last 1 month, hoping that the serious questions which have been raised after Sushant Singh Rajput's suicide go away. No, Mayank, they won't. They're going to stay to haunt the Bollywood lobby for a very long time. Kasturi Shankar will join us. Akashdeep Sabir will join us. And on the side which says the Bollywood lobby exists, Vani Tripathi Tikku, she's a board member of the CBFC and an actor herself, Ravina Raj Kohli. She's a very senior television executive, former president of Star News, Harinder Sikka, author and writer. Apurva Asrani, filmmaker and writer. Sonal Mansingh is on our screen, needs no introduction. Member of Parliament and very well-known legendary classical dancer. Malavika Avinash, actor, politician. Savita Raj Hiremath and Ishkaran Bhandari, who works with Subramaniam Swami, are going to be joining us. Let's start with a one-minute opening remarks on both sides. I'd like to pit Mayank Shekhar with Vani. First, let's start by talking about the Bollywood lobby. Has it stifled? Let Mayank speak first. Has this rumble which has now started, what is the response of the Bollywood mafia to it, Mayank?
Okay, I think a couple of things here. Firstly, the use of the word mafia is a bit dangerous.
No, I like to go into dangerous territory. Don't tell me about dangers. It's not
dangerous for you, Arnab. It's dangerous for people that you're mentioning and you're exposing them to the sort of public shaming culture that exists.
I'm saying
online.
There's a Bollywood lobby.
It's not a good thing to do.
You are the one who's identifying people with part of the Bollywood lobby. Who is the part of the Bollywood mafia? Who are you identifying? Who are you protecting? Who are you protecting, Mayank Shekhar? Who are you speaking on behalf of? Kangana Ranaut spoke about it. Is there a Bollywood lobby or not? Is there a Bollywood lobby or not? Tell me. Is there a Bollywood lobby? There is talk of a lobby. There is talk of a lobby that has capitalized, monopolized, and banished those who don't serve their interests in the industry. Why are you so defensive? There is a Bollywood lobby.
What is Bollywood? Bollywood is not a country. Well, let me talk now.
You're so nervous, man.
Why are you asking me a question?
You're so nervous, man.
Arey, yaar, let me talk no first.
I haven't even browbeaten you.
Bollywood is not a country. Bollywood is not a government department. Bollywood is not a hotel. Bollywood essentially...
Don't teach me English. Carry on.
Federation.
Don't teach me English.
Federation.
Carry on.
There is no word
Don't
in English.
Don't teach me English. Carry on. English?
It is not an English word in dictionary. Bollywood is not a word in the English dictionary. I'm not teaching you English. You need to understand what Bollywood is. It is not a hotel. It is not a government department that owes something to the taxpayer. It is a loose federation of artists with multiple talents and entrepreneurs who get together to make films. All right? Now, in that situation, there is no prime minister or a president of Bollywood. There are multiple people working. There are people who... Nobody...
Hello, are you giving me a history lesson? Why don't you answer the question? Listen. One second. Listen to me. You're on television right now. Right? Did you hear Kangana Ranaut? Did you hear her?
I agree with her. Don't get me wrong. Yeah. If the larger idea is to address...
Give me Rahul. Don't talk like Rahul Gandhi. Don't talk like Rahul Gandhi. It's an idea. I'm talking substance.
What is
India
substance?
Is an idea.
Is
poverty substance? Is a state of mind.
You are accusing people of...
Poverty is a state of mind. India is an idea. What is this?
Calling people mafia...
Speak sense.
And
don't talk like Rahul Gandhi.
Is a substance.
Don't talk like Rahul Gandhi.
What is Rahul Gandhi to do with this now?
I'm saying this, though, poverty is a state of mind, India is an idea. Don't be generalizing with me. I'm asking you one thing. If you have the guts, come into the debate right now. Wait a minute, Mayank Shekhar. Wait a minute. I pit you on the debate with Vani on the other side, right? Vani's audio is not through. So I'll get anyone else on the other side. No problem. Who'd like to come in? Because this man has lost his shirt right on top today.
I'll go.
Yeah? One minute. Vani is back now. Okay, Vani, if I can have you back. See, Vani, I've begun with these Rahul Gandhi type comments being expressed by Mayank Shekhar. Bollywood is an idea. We are a group of talented people who work in a talented way.
Why are you misquoting me? I'm sitting right here.
Yeah. See, he says
Bollywood is an idea.
Oh, freak me out. Don't freak me out. Relax.
What?
Now, question is this. Kangana Ranaut speaking to me said that there is a movie mafia that tolerates outsiders only if they toe their line. And she talked about the suicide gang that is driving people up the wall. The issue is, Vani, this is a crime. Now, he asks me, why do you call them mafia? Well, if a crime is carried out in an institutionalized way, I don't know which school you learnt English in. If a crime is carried out in the manner of a syndicate or an institutionalized way, it is called a mafia. You understand, Mayank? Or did the PR companies in Bollywood not teach you that?
Are you accusing me of being a PR agent?
No, I'm saying did the PR... because the PR machinery is very active in Bollywood. Are they not existing? Is there not a PR machinery in Bollywood? Come on now.
The PR machinery in Bollywood, yes.
Yeah, there, thank you. Thank you, now you're talking. Now you're talking.
No, not denying it.
What have you done to destroy the PR machinery?
Not denying
it. What have you done to destroy the PR machinery, Mayank Shekhar? What have you done to it? Have you cozied up to them? Are you part of it?
Are you accusing me of that?
I'm saying, are you part of it?
Are you accusing me, Arnav? Are you genuinely accusing me of...
I'm asking you straight up, in the only way that I know.
Yes.
There are tentacles of this lobby which need to be chopped off. I'd like Vani to enter the debate on whether the Bollywood lobby has stifled talent. A necessary debate that has unfortunately been precipitated following the suicide of Sushant Singh Rajput. Vani.
I remember the day Sushant passed away, I was on your program. In fact, a lot of my fraternity later said that there was some courage that you actually went on Arnav's show that day. One, it was tremendously heartbreaking personally for me because I knew Sushant and his talent level and I spoke about it glaringly that day. Let me first put this on record that this conspiracy of silence which exists, I will go beyond the word Bollywood. We are an Indian film industry. Bollywood is a poor cousin. It sounds like a cheap word of whatever is Hollywood, and you know, there are so many Hollywoods in the country. But this conspiracy of silence, very sadly, is decimating itself. I don't know if the glass ceiling is still broken. In the wake of a huge human tragedy, the loss of Sushant Singh Rajput. Number two, stifling talent is a very small word, Arnav. The industry functions in multifarious styles of destroying human spirit. And I think the whole fact that human spirit can be destroyed, art is destroyed, artistry is destroyed, and talent levels are stifled. As far as the PR and the marketing machinery of the film industry goes, the Most High and the Mighty, they may be the A-list stars of the country, don't even bat an eyelid without asking a PR manager. This is how their careers are constructed and, according to me, destroyed. It's not constructed, they are destroyed. So anybody who does not have the courage or the capaciousness to look within the wake of this horrendous tragedy of Sushant going away, passing away like this, should actually look within, number one. And number two, he's left a very deep message for the industry. And that is, if we will continue to be so incestuous and myopic, exactly the way we are, like the socio-political dialects of the country who sit on high chairs with absolute zero talent and want to run the country, want to run corporations, it will be doomsday. Remember, we are speaking to each other in this dystopian time, which is this lockdown and this COVID.
Guest.
If the industry will remain in denial of whatever Sushant's tragedy has brought in its wake, then I think it's doomsday. And anybody who doesn't agree with what I am saying, I will go beyond the word nepotism. It's a dense situation. Contracts are formulated legally, which bind you to an extent. I mean, it's almost like being bonded labor. If this culture, if this kind of, you know, we have to go on semantics when we are talking about this. If this environment, this ecosystem doesn't change, if we don't recalibrate as an industry, something else is going to occur and that is going to be limited.
I thank you for your opening remarks, Swani. And Mayank Shekhar wants to teach us English. Have you heard the word venal? Have you heard the word venomous? Have you heard the word insecure? Have you heard the word stifling? I'm sure you've heard the word nepotistic. I'm sure you've heard the word undeserving. Have you heard these words, Mayank? Reminds you of someone?
Yes.
Now, there's an episode. There's an episode. So don't teach us English next time. I'll throw descriptors at you. One minute, Mayank. Relax. I'll give you an example now. I'll give you an example. Alia Bhatt goes on Karan Johar's show. The show described appropriately, very appropriately by Kangana as frivolous. There's no problem with frivolity. There is a problem with unintelligent frivolity. And the question asked is, who would you kill, marry, or hook up with? Look at the words used, Sameer Soni.
It's a game.
It's a game. It's not a game. It's not a game. You don't kill people in games. Ridiculous. Don't be stupid. What do you mean game? What do you mean game? And Alia Bhatt said, I would marry Ranbir, I would kill Sushant.
It's a game.
No. I would kill. Why would you kill? No, why do you use the word kill? Why do you use the word kill?
They don't literally.
No. One minute. Why would you kill? Why would you use the word kill? I can understand marry or hook up. Why would you kill? I'm sorry. Why would you kill? Why would you kill in a game? Okay, so tell me another game in which you kill people. Sonal Mansingh. No. Tell me another game. One second. Tell me another game in which you would kill people. If I were to ask you, we are all on the program right now. Let's play a little game, Mayank.
Yeah.
Let's play a little. The 11 of us on the screen.
Let's
who would you kill?
Monopoly. Let's play Monopoly.
No. One second. Let's play a game, Mayank. Let's play a game, Mayank. There are 11 of us on the screen. Who would you kill? And the answer is, I would kill Sushant.
The problem with that show is,
why would you kill? Why would you want to kill someone? Why would you even want to kill someone? Oh, don't tell me a game. It's a stupid game if that's a game. Sonal Mansingh is on the debate.
Of course.
Sonal, I think it's a descriptor of insecurity. It's a classical descriptor of insecurity. Both the person questioning and answering are very insecure people. Sonal Mansingh is on the debate. Let's open up the can of worms tonight. Sonal Mansingh is on the debate with Sameer Soni. Yeah. Sonal Mansingh first. Yeah.
Yeah. I have two, three very quick points. Nobody should think that I'm an outsider, and therefore, what do I know? I have gathered so much information of late, and the word is not even shocking, it is scary. Scary information. There are more than 10 gangs active. They're all interlinked. What I want to say is, Vani talked about Corona. I think that the pandemic of corruption in Bollywood has reached its peak, and it needs to be flattened out. Unless that happens, I don't know where it will go. It has really reached its peak. Number three, I would like to quote from the Mahabharata, the character of Duryodhan. Listen carefully, please. He said, Janami dharmam nacha me pravritti. Janami adharmam nacha me nivritti. I know what dharma is, but I cannot do it. I will not follow it. I know what is adharma, what I should not do, but I have no chutkara from it. I go on doing it. And I think that's exactly the point where Bollywood is today. All those perpetrators of various things which are dark acts, There's a dark belly there, underbelly. They know what they're doing. They can't get out of it. It's a vicious spiral. As you said, unless the tentacles are chopped off, there is not going to be any chutkara. And I hope the sooner it happens, the better for everyone. Number four, somebody talked about that this is not a taxpayers, we are not, something like that, I think, Mr. Mayank Shekhar.
Yeah, Mayank.
I would like to remind him, it's a taxpayers' money of the audience that feeds Bollywood. We should never forget that. The responsibility, yeah. The dharma towards your vast audience.
Yeah, absolutely. I think you put it very, very gracefully and very well. You know, the issue is, Sonal Mansingh, let me tell you one thing about this media and Bollywood. It's the most shameless, self-serving, parasitic relationship I have seen in my life. The only way to get an interview of a quote-unquote star is through a PR company. There are some PR companies which control all. And nobody, including Mayank Shekhar, has the guts to speak one word about them. I'm not saying he's part of it because he'll jump. Question is, I'd like to ask you, Sameer Soni, before giving you an opportunity to speak. I will not give you a platform. I'll give you an opportunity, Sameer. And let's see if you have the guts. I think it's an award function. I don't know which one. I don't know, Filmfare or some award function. Okay? And everyone's on this, please. Shah Rukh Khan and Saif Khan. Shah Rukh Khan and Saif Khan. Did I hear someone say, he who shall not be named? Shah Rukh Khan and Saif Khan are on the screen. All right, Bharti. Shah Rukh Khan and Saif Khan. There's Neil Nitin Mukesh in the audience. And one of them, Shah Rukh or Saif, I think one of them or both together, ask Neil Nitin Mukesh. Mujhe tumse ek sawal puchna hai ki tumhara naam hai Neil Nitin Mukesh. Bhaiya, surname kahan pe hai? It's not a game. It's not a game. Bhaiya, surname kahan pe hai? And he's shocked. He's shocked because, you know, who doesn't know Mukesh ji? Who in India doesn't know Mukesh? Who doesn't know Nitin ji? How can you say that? And then there is a sequence where the whole of Bollywood is there shamelessly slithering on. And he says, do you have a name? We are the Khans. Tum ho kaun? There, don't tell me about descriptors. It was a way of saying, we are the Khans. Tum ho kaun? Tum ho kaun? Now tell me, Sameer, did Shah Rukh Khan not know about playback singer Nitin Mukesh or Mukesh ji? Does Shah Rukh Khan not know about him? Tell me, let's take names today. Let's take names.
I'm sure he did.
Then why did he do that? Why did Shah Rukh and Saif insult deliberately? It was a way of putting Neil Nitin Mukesh down. Was it or was it not? Tell me, Sameer. Tell me.
Look.
Tell me, there's nothing here, there, boss. Tell me. Tell me. Tell me.
I'll be very...
No, tell me.
Yes, honest.
Yeah.
Okay. If we are arguing...
No, I'm not arguing theoretically. I'm giving you an example. I have the guts to talk about the example I spoke about. Shah Rukh Khan and Saif on screen. Everyone saw nobody's running away in this debate, okay? None of you are slithering away, okay? Don't try and get out of my question. Shah Rukh Khan and Saif Khan, you know that, right? Payal, you know that. On the screen, on the stage, telling him, hum, we are Khans, who are you? And Nitin Mukesh is sitting next to his son. Shame on him. I mean, I'd ask you one thing. What if someone were to take someone's parent's name in this way and mock you? Let me be very direct today. Akashdeep, don't mumble. What if someone were to take your parents' name and mock you in public like the way Shah Rukh and Saif did? What? Why? What? What I?
Arnav, it was part of a scripted joke, Arnav.
Joke? Oh, it's a joke when it's played on someone else. Sonal Mansi, it's a joke.
A scripted joke.
It's a joke.
Yes,
it's a scripted joke.
Yes,
you pick on.
No qualms.
Okay, so it's a Sonal Mansi. It's a joke.
In our own fraternity, oh, we can
right,
laugh
right,
at
right,
ourselves.
Right. It's a joke. You kill someone.
Tomorrow,
you want to
you
kill someone. It's a joke.
That we can, we are
who,
not ready
who are you? It's a joke.
Arnav, you're not. Arnav, you're not
wonderful,
ready to listen to anybody today. You're not ready to listen to
the
other side today. What happened?
Listen to people. Sonal Mansi will respond to you. Joke. Malavika, he says joke. Let Malavika Avinash
respond. Sonal Mansi has been totally generic in
such a joke
statement.
Been played on them?
Can she substantiate with one actual statement?
One
generic,
second. Sonal Mansi. Malavika Avinash, who would like
Bollywood.
To come in now?
Come on, show me an example.
This
show
Malavika
me an
is
example.
Responding.
This
we're
is
talking
intolerable.
About the influence of successful
intolerable.
People.
And what is,
that
what is more
everywhere.
Shocking?
No, Arnab.
Hello?
No, Arnab.
What
highly
is,
exaggerated. Highly
what
exaggerated.
Is more shocking is that all the Bollywood bigwigs kept quiet. That is shocking. Nobody spoke up. That's shocking.
Nobody kept quiet, Sonal.
This is
nobody kept quiet. Yeah. Everybody
Malavika.
Tweeted.
Malavika.
You
thank you, Malavika.
You not to read. Everyone tweeted.
Malavika is responding to the specific example
silent?
I shared.
Who tells
Malavika,
you Bollywood
Malavika,
was not
Malavika,
affected?
Malavika and Malavika,
please. Everyone
was
shocked
nobody
by
wanted to speak.
Dead.
Nobody dared to speak. And today here is a woman called Kangana Ranaut who comes out
everyone
and speaks.
Spoke.
I admire her. I applaud her.
How can you talk like this? How can
all
you
all these biggies
louder.
Who
Malavika.
Been for so long running this mafia. And it doesn't end at just money. There's much more to it. You heard Dr. Swami. There is a communal element to it too. And Kangana has the guts to call it out. Face it, guys. Come up with real answers. Don't call it a scripted one and all that. Why is it that that boy was shot? If it was scripted, why was he not informed? He was sitting in the audience. For him, it was not scripted. For the question, for the, those who are asking the questions, it's scripted. It was shocking to watch the video. That's the least to say. And let me tell you, Arnab, this is not something that is exclusive to Mumbai. There is nepotism in every film industry across the country, in every region, in every language. They are either small or big, but there is. And the newcomer struggles, fights. Some of them stay on. Some of them end up like Sushant. Right? We are the big mouths who stay on. Now answer me, Mr. Whoever, who said it's a scripted show.
Silence on the other side today.
What?
Wonderful. Sameer, what? Have you lost what? Your voice or have I lost your audio?
Where is the silence?
Sameer, have I lost? Have you, have you lost your voice or have you lost your voice or have I lost your audio?
No, you didn't let me talk.
Yeah.
I'll be very straight and honest. I'm an outsider.
Sameer, Sonia, and Ravina Raj, please on the screen. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, please.
Sameer, make your point. Make your point, then I'll ask you my question.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, sure. Fair enough. Look, I am an outsider. I've been in the business, in the industry for 20 years. I'm not related to anyone. I have had my struggle. I don't know how successful or unsuccessful I am. I mean, I can't generalize. Obviously, I'm not one of the superstars and stuff. So I've got no favors from any nepotistic gang or whatever you want to call these people. My statement is simple. If you're asking, does nepotism exist? Of course it exists. You have to be blind and foolish to deny that.
Can you be more specific? You know, one thing I've decided today on the program is not to be theoretical. I'm not here to give each other English lessons.
So one minute.
You know, Shah Rukh Khan puts out quotes on Twitter, does he?
Yeah, I don't read them, but yeah.
But anyway, so let's presume he does. Let's presume a few of them do, right?
Right.
Do you say that he's someone who cannot be, there's something, some problem with him? This lobby, what I call the lobby, okay? Now, here's one specific example. This lobby has no depth. And about Sushant. Sushant. One minute. I'm going to prove that Sushant was ridiculed and mocked for a very long time in a systematic way by an insecure lobby, which is the very question, Ravina, they don't want to address. They want to make general statements, and Sameer Soni is heading in the direction of a general statement. I'll tell you what Sameer would have said. I'll tell you what Sameer would have said, Ravina.
Okay,
he would have said, hey, listen, I'm from outside. I don't know whether I've been successful or unsuccessful. As far as a lobby, sure, it exists. But, hey, a lobby exists everywhere, so it's not good, but it exists. And let's move on.
No.
I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that.
I'm not going to do that either.
I'm not going to do that. I saw a clip. I saw a clip of Karan Johar. After the interview with Kangana was played. 1 minute. After the interview with Kangana was played. Sameer. After the interview was played, someone sent me the clip saying, you know, Arnab, this is the clip Kangana was talking about. And there is Karan Johar at I'm told it's London School of Economics, where he sits and he says, listen, I am sick and tired, he says, of this victim number. I'm sick and tired of the woman number. Listen.
Okay.
He says, I'm sick and tired of her woman card. Ravina, mark the words. Woman card. Victim card. So Kangana, according to Karan, is playing a woman card. And he says, you don't like Bollywood? Leave it. Nikal jao. And then in a very coarse and vulgar manner, he says, tum logon ne chane ke jhaad pe bitha ke rakha hai. Look at the way he talks about her. No, one second. Look at the way it's coarse, it's vulgar, it's cheap, it's demeaning. And I want to know from you, Sameer, what is the woman card which Kangana is playing according to Karan Johar? What do you feel about the use of words like woman card to describe one of India's most talented actors in contemporary India? You accuse her of playing a woman card.
I saw Kangana's debate. Debate last night.
No, tell me about the...
You're asking me about that. I saw Kangana's debate last night. I have been following her. I have great admiration in terms of the guts she has to stand up to these people. But as far as I am concerned, when I heard her interview, I was like, there were just allegations, calling people names. She was saying so and so.
No. I'm not throwing an allegation at you. Don't try and slither away, Sameer. I'm not talking about allegations. I'm talking about a tape. You want me to play the tape? You want me to play the tape? You want me to play the tape? The use of the word was, listen, calm down. The use of the word, I'm not talking of allegations. I'm talking about the tape. In the tape, which you're trying to avoid my question, in the tape, a use of a word, woman card. I am intrigued. I want to know what is the woman card. What is the quote-unquote woman card? What is the woman card? What is the woman card? Man card. What is the woman card? 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 What you have accused a person in an international forum of using a woman card. What is a woman card? The nation wants to know what is the woman card.
Arnab, do you have the courage to hear the truth on national TV?
No, I am asking you about the tape now. 1 minute.
To hear it?
I am asking you, do you have the courage to answer the question, what is the woman card?
I'll tell you. Okay.
Woman card. One second. Let's take a pause for a while, you and me, right? Okay, 1 minute.
Okay.
1 minute. Take a pause. And I'm asking you, I'm going to come back to you. Ravina, the use of the word was woman card. What is a woman card? And why are the self-proclaimed feminists of Bollywood not speaking up about that?
Can I respond?
May I answer now? Oh, let Sameer finish.
No, I haven't got even a chance
please,
to
Sameer.
Answer.
No, please.
I didn't get a chance to say a word. All I can said one thing, and Arnab is challenging me, and I'm going to give him a reaction of what I thought what Kangana said. And I'm going to take a big risk. I am telling you, Kangana is shooting off a dead man's shoulder to shoot her guns.
How unfortunate. Look at that, Sonal. Look at that. I'm going to take reactions to that. I need everyone on the screen. I'm going to take reactions to that. I'm going to take reactions to that. Starting with Ravina. Everyone's on. No, we'll keep everyone on. You have said that. Now there's no going back on that. Now there's no going back on that. There is no going back on that now, Ravina. Ravina, please respond. Thank you. He avoided my question. He avoided my question. And he has accused Kangana of shooting off the shoulders of Sushant. 1 minute. This is 1 minute. Ravina, please respond. Bani, anyone, who's coming in?
I want to say a couple of things, Arnab, about this. But if somebody else wants to talk, they may speak, because I don't want to argue.
Vani, 1 minute, please. Please respond quickly because you've got many people responding to that statement here. Yes.
Yeah.
Go on, Ravina. Go on fast.
Oh, Ravina. Okay. Arnab, I want to ask you a question. We are talking about nepotism. We are talking about unequal opportunity. We are talking about lobbies. Why aren't we questioning the business and the business decision makers that feed off this? I think a lot of the stuff you see, whether it's a cheap Bollywood script meant to just create tumult on social media to get more eyeballs, to create more conversations. This entire spider's web that has been created, you know, the half-baked PR lobby, not all of them are experienced enough to even give the correct advice to their clients. Okay, so you've got a PR machinery, you've got a struggling actor, you've got a television channel, you've got a media brands. All of these are working together. And I take serious objection to anybody saying that Kangana is using the woman card. I don't think she needs to. I think she has gone way beyond that. Way beyond that. And I think there is a certain meanness that has emerged from all these debates on A, how the people who have made it in the business view the people who have not yet made it. There is a
no, Ravina, I'm very specific. Ravina, I'm very specific. I'll theorize later. Sorry to butt in right there. I want to go to Vani. I want to go to Sonal Mansingh because it was just said by this man, Sameer Soni, that Kangana. You know, I would have expected you, Sameer, to have the courage to call the Bollywood lobby the vultures.
It doesn't take courage
to call the Bollywood lobby the vultures. If you lack that courage, it's not my problem. I think the Bollywood lobby are the vultures. But you said Kangana is shooting off Sushant's shoulder, right? Not Ravina. Please, everyone on the screen, thank you very much. I'm getting Sonal Mansingh to respond to that. Sonal Mansingh.
Misogynist remark I've heard in a long time, in a long, long time.
Okay.
And unfortunately, even today, the most talented, wonderfully talented women are finally getting such remarks from so-called intelligent people. I mean, it just shows the
mindset. What has that done with sexism?
And it's just to be criticized and deplored. It's deplorable.
I'd like to play a clip, ladies and gentlemen. Here it is.
I want to say I'm done with Kangana playing the woman card and the victim card. I'm done. I mean, you cannot be this victim at every given point of time who has a sad story to tell about how you've been terrorized by the bad world of the industry. Leave it. Who's forcing you on a gunpoint to be here in the movies? Leave. Do something else.
No, I think maybe, and I'm trying to interpret what she meant here, but maybe.
But all of you only chane ke jhaad pe upar ab daloge, so then this is what happens.
It's all my fault.
you know that squealing and giggling moderator and that clapping crowd is equally revolting.
This is what it's all about. Yeah.
So I
tell you what is playing out.
Vani.
All Sushant's passing away, you know, as a script. Somebody mentioned that these award shows are scripted. Yes, they are, and cheaply so. If this is the kind of entertainment we are putting out, this is the public interface. These award shows are the public interface of the stars with the world. I belong to the fraternity. I belong to the industry. I've also been to a lot of award functions.
What moral
each
lesson are you giving on the show?
Job
all of you are desperately looking for a platform to sound different.
Let's remember, when you insinuate somebody, when you insult somebody, it's real. And if this is this,
it an insult because you're behaving like an outsider. It also shows that we have the capacity to laugh at ourselves.
I've been listening to everybody. Let me at least speak. You can come to me. I'm sure I will give you a moment or two.
I'm saying that you are just passing generic statements. It's not fair.
Second
It also shows that we have the capacity to laugh at ourselves.
Yeah.
You are Vani, now Vani, yourself Vani, Vani, Vani.
Thank you, Vani.
And deciding that, oh, that humor
speaking.
Is cheap. Why are you saying
and
that?
The second most, and the second most gag, important thing in this script, this why social script
you didn't like it.
That the patriarchy and the misogyny that women have to pay every single day in the country is very much a part of the film industry.
Oh, come on.
And you know what is irritating?
Everyone who's against this is only speaking generic. Can you show me the mafia?
In the past one decade. Suddenly, the protagonist is a woman. The misnomer used to be if the protagonist is a woman, the film wouldn't work.
Kangana has a problem with everybody.
Whether it's a Bhoomi Pednekar, whether it is a Tapsee Pannu, they are changing the narrative. And this is also irritating the grand old triarchs of the film industry. They can't digest the fact that here you have films which have women protagonists, which have a Vidya Balan in it, the film works in the box office, and their own hero, gun popping, killing 35 ghouls, and the babe in the woods being, the babe in the woods routine is not playing out for them. So this change of narrative is a puncture into that misogyny and that patriarchy, and they can't handle it. They are just not able to handle it. Yeah. And in the last decade, this has been the most time-changing narrative as far as films is concerned, and women are a part of it.
Yeah. And Samir, you spoke about courage. Go first go and tell the people in your industry who go running to the Dubai Bhais, tell them who those who go running to the Dubai Bhais and to the Chota Shakil bootlickers of the Bollywood industry. Tell them to gather some guts before you give me a lesson.
Okay.
Okay. Payal is on the debate with you. Payal is on the debate. Payal takes you on. Payal. Payal has something to say to you. Payal.
Thank you for coming to me. Okay. I just want to say one thing. First of all, Kangana is not a woman who ever plays a feminist card. She has taken on everybody head on, and that is why I kind of support her, though I have not even met her. So please don't say that Kangana is using the woman card. She has challenged everybody, whether she has worked with them, she has not worked with them. She has called out a Sonam Kapoor, but she has obviously gone ahead and worn her clothes also. She is not a biased lady. So don't say she's playing a woman card.
I never said a woman's card.
Women card, when they want to spread Hindu phobia or they want to abuse, they want to make fun of Hindu gods, everything feminism does. But feminism does not talk about the nepotism or the casting couch present in Bollywood. So let's not get into the fact that Kangana is playing the woman card. She has the right to talk, just like you all have the right to talk. Coming to the Karan Johar clip. Now, Karan Johar, sir, he is obviously a great filmmaker. He has obviously got a great family lineage, but he's no one to tell that she should leave Bollywood. Why should anybody leave Bollywood? People are going to say that because Payal is not so successful, she's bitter. But let's not get to me. Kangana is at least successful. So even though, in spite of being successful, she is opening up the Pandora's box, everybody who is an outsider needs to sit down and hear to her. Because here it's not about her controversy with Hrithik. I have supported Hrithik in a lot of endeavors of his. I don't hate Hrithik, but here the talk is about nepotism. The talk is about why Sushant Singh Rajput was pushed to the wall so that he felt worthless, whether his death was due to a suicide
or
whether
it was a pre-planned controversy. Whom are you taking
on? We have the D-gang. Why do jokes have to be made in award functions, kind of making fun of Neel Nitin Mukesh? Why can't jokes be made on Khan's surname? Why does Karan Johar not talk about the regressive stuff in other religion? Why does it always have to be, our religion, PK is made. You want to laugh, you want to make fun, you want to take a joke on yourself. Instead of making PK, make another film which talks about triple talaq. So here I'm not going to get into the religion debate, but just don't give me the garb that you guys are trying to laugh at yourself. You want to promote the Khan surname? Whoa. Well, the Khan surname, the Khan Market gang is not going to be promoted because there was a time when a lot of people changed their name, like a Jagdeep Ji also changed his name and to get an entry into Bollywood. But that's not going to happen. No Khan rules Bollywood.
Bollywood. Bollywood is an industry which, like some lady said very aptly, it is a part of the Indian film industry where people work due to their talent. You cannot subdue talent. In Bollywood, there was a systematic attack on Sushant Singh Rajput. There's a lot of stuff that I'm talking about him and through my videos because I feel somewhere I need to talk about him. Fans were writing to him, the so-called troll fans, which was obviously engineered by a PR machinery, telling him that Sushant sir, don't die soon. Excuse me, you were actually putting thoughts in his head. I have screenshots of people, so-called fans, telling Sushant, don't die soon. Like, Fire, you know, Karan Johar said in his show.
This is nothing from the horse's mouth. You are just...
Hello. So there have been seeds instilled inside him that don't die, don't do anything stupid. That's what Kangana is pointing out. Why should anybody tell you that don't commit suicide? Excuse me, look at your people and your children in spite of giving them so many breaks. I don't want to take names. Where are they? How many breaks does Karan Johar give to whoever he wants to, but they're still there. Okay, you want to just harp about the talent of Alia and Ranveer? Go ahead. But that does not mean they comprise, they end, they make and end Bollywood. No, they are one of the people who have done some good work in Bollywood, but Bollywood does not comprise of them. So please don't divert from the main topic. The feminists are fake in India. They either open their mouth when it is anything related to Hinduism, they open or they just shut and run inside their bills if it is anything related to any other religion. Now, why are they supporting Kangana in this whole woman card debate? And Sameer Soni ji, I respect you a lot. You're a very good human being, but you should have not made the statement that she's trying to, you know, fulfill her agenda through a dead man's shoulder.
The very critical point. One second. Who's responding?
And that's why I said, I intentionally said that, Payal. Payal, give me a second. I'll intentionally said that because I saw the debate with Arnob, which Kangana had for like whatever, 1 hour or 45 minutes. We were discussing the death of Sushant. I have worked in the same set with Sushant when he was doing his last TV show and I was doing a TV show. I was very fond of him. We, you know, passed and said hello, highs. I was proud of him. Okay, now my question is that I was following this case very closely. His doctor, psychiatrist, Carey, I think his name is, he came out in the open and he came out in the open and said that he was suffering bipolar disease. Now, bipolar disease, I have done my homework. 40% rate of people who suffer from bipolar are capable of either killing themselves or harming themselves. That's a statistics I'm giving you for bipolar. He was under medication.
Oh my God! Now,
right?
Now, see, no, I'll tell you. One second. Just a minute. Just a minute. Pyle is responding. So you know what? Somebody's psychotic. Somebody's bipolar.
Why? Why isn't that?
No. One minute. Pyle.
If you really care, why isn't that point coming up, Sameer sir? If he was taking treatment for bipolar, then obviously.
He was taking treatment. The doctors were giving him treatment. He was under medication. In spite of that, you're saying that a person was taking treatment committed suicide. No, sir. Bipolar is a tag that people put on your head when they don't agree with you. People have called me bipolar. People have just called me names, sir. You cannot just say that Percy Chavda is a fake psychiatrist present on planet Earth, sir. You cannot get into that zone.
Read what bipolar is.
Why did his family stay with him? He was so depressed.
I can't hear you, sir. A family person who was diagnosed bipolar.
No.
Don't tell me, okay?
Do not teach me psychology.
Language. I'm talking to you with respect. Don't call me bloody.
I have a family friend who was bipolar. Do not teach me psychology, and he was being treated for it. But why aren't you guys raising that point, and you're talking about Kangana, just a minute, please.
Thank you. I said I'm entering the debate. Thank you, Sameer. If someone were to say to you that you are a psychotic, If someone were to say to you that you are a overpaid outsider,
disorder.
If someone were to say to you you're an overpaid outsider, you're a psychotic. You get more than you deserve. If someone were to say all that to you, would it not have an impact on you? You don't want to go to the root cause. Ravina is on the debate. Ravina is on the debate. What you're saying is pathetic. You should talk about the Bootlickers Club, which is trying to control the narrative. There's someone who wrote a blind item about Sushant Singh Rajput being an overpaid outsider. Being an overpaid outsider. And dedicated the first half of that interview to promoting a film made by a famous director's son. What are you talking about? Talk about the Bootlickers Lobby. Talk about the reality. You will not pin the blame on Sushant. See, your problem is you're not going on the issue at all. Why would you mock Sushant? Why would you mock Sushant's intelligence? Why would you ridicule Sushant's family? Why would you do that? Did Bollywood not do that? That hangs on your conscience.
You don't have the guts to speak.
The truth is that there is a lobby. There is an insider circle. There is an outsider circle. There are more opportunities than there were, but it is still not an equal opportunity. Business very much depends on your personal equations, your professionalism, and your talent comes second. Let's face it, that is the truth. Okay?
I agree. That's the industry that we are dealing with. I've been anti-nepotism.
Yeah.
What are we talking about?
Nepotism,
I mean, you have a grand old party of the Gandhis, whose forefathers and
Stay on the subject. Harinder Sikka is on the debate. You want to have some evidence to show on that program? 1 second. Harinder Sikka is on the debate. Ladies and gentlemen, before I bring into come into Harinder Sikka, I just want to say that in my view, Sushant rattled Bollywood. Kangana rattles Bollywood even more. Kangana rattles Bollywood, the Bollywood mafia, the Bollywood lobby, because she's not a bystander. Sameer, listen to me now. She's not a bystander. She annoys the Bollywood mafia because she does not swallow her pride and remain a bystander to this shafting of merit. She annoys the Bollywood lobby because when they say nepotism rocks, she does not fawn at them, she hits back. She calls out the reality of it all.
Come on.
And I believe one of the reasons she's...
Arnab, can I come in here, please?
Well, Sameer, you don't even have the ability to take 3 or 4 straight comments from me. I will say it, she annoys even you. Kangana annoys even you because she says no to films with a Khan.
She dismisses everyone.
And then she openly declares, why can't I say no to a film? She annoys you. She has more guts than you. You talk about courage. She has displayed more guts than all of you put together, Sameer. And you know this. You know this, that she is moving.
Because
she's willing to speak up against injustice on behalf of all. And because she may remind even you. She may even remind you that in your younger days you did not have the courage to speak out like she has and done.
I came on your debate and said against nepotism.
Because she's not ready to be held hostage by the PR machinery. She annoys you. Because all of you, including Mayank, know she's right and you're wrong. I'd like Harinder Sikka to come on the debate.
I have come on your debate against nepotism.
Thank you, Harinder.
I have come on your debate.
Thank you, Sameer. Harinder also. Let's get
Arnab. Arnab, you don't want theory, you want a proof. I wrote Razi. And I'll show you a proof how between... this is a proof against by name Gulzar. Was written to me by Jaipur Literature Festival. I was removed from everything, from Filmfare, from Penguin. My book was not allowed to be launched by Gulzar in person. You want me to read this email or I'll text it to you? Read it to them. Jaipur Literature Festival head says, in my 35 years of career, I have never seen anybody bulldozing me to remove one in number person. In this particular case, Gulzar is the case in point. What he did, I was removed my book was tried to be delayed. Why? Every credit must go to Meghna Gulzar. Jaipur Literature Festival. Then Filmfare Award.
Then the Best Original Story Award was to be given to me. It was removed and given to some film by the name Andhadhun, which was a copy of a French book, because I was to be removed. And then it is not the only one. What did Meghna do further? Chapak. She took away that poor writer, that lawyer in Delhi, who's her credit away. Ask Ravi Tandon, Ravina Tandon's father, what happened. There's a history of mafia operating. I have nothing against nobody. It's not my profession. It's not my business. My business is with the very one of the finest groups in the country. But this occurs over here. This happens too because I was an outsider. My film, which was to go to the Oscar award, Nanak Shah Fakir, was not allowed to be gone because somebody came from Bollywood. He says, oh, he's an outsider. We will send our picture. So this is happening. Somebody wants proof. I'm carrying a proof here. Please film it and show it to the world. That this is what Jaipur Literature Festival wrote. Yeah. Yeah.
No, the point is, Mayank, 1 minute. Thank you, Harinder.
You want to show this?
1 minute, 1 minute,
to the world?
1 minute. Just a minute. There is an attempt. There is an attempt at trying to create some kind of a duopoly, monopoly. The allegations are not hard to decipher. The claims are that there is an attempt to create a monopoly, duopoly situation, that there is a circuit which tries to decide what to retain, who to toss. And they have people, Mayank, and don't jump every time, are you talking about me? If you have that kind of inner feeling about yourself, I can't help it. Okay? So I'm saying that there are a group of people who call themselves journalists. They are nothing but sellouts. They fawn over these people shamelessly. They're bootlickers, do their bidding. They have no respect for themselves also. And there is this vertical cartel-like axis that has been created out here. Okay, you have to be part of a solidified vertical cartel that holds, and that cartel must dominate and dismiss those who they dislike in the industry. And if you want to be anywhere, want to get any access, if you want to write a book, if you want to write a column, right, if you want to have a TV program, then you must go along with them. Okay, so what I'm saying is, you would do yourself some good, Mayank. I repeat, you would do yourself some good today if you were to accept this reality instead of going further into your eggshell, digging a deeper hole in the ground and burying your head desperately within it, saying,
not
no,
all.
It's all
not
lies. All. It's not true.
Not
Abhinav Singh
at
Kashyap
no point,
is not true.
No point.
There is no clever mix of money, clout and connections. And everybody is wrong. But you know what? You would be blind to one thing.
Not
see the support for Kangana.
Enough.
1 minute, last word. Listen to the whole thing.
One word
see
you
the
or
support
one word you give...
or for Kangana and realize you've been called out.
Okay.
You as in the Bollywood groups have been
yes.
called out. Yeah.
So the whole point I've been trying to make, Arnab, and please don't get me wrong, at no point am I suggesting that there is
what
no injustice of any kind. We run stories.
Don't generalize.
And I've been doing for 2 decades now. Story.
Don't generalize.
Story.
What was the woman card which Karan Johar accused Kangana of playing?
We do this
was
story.
It right of
we
Karan to tell? 1 minute on the debate. I'll be very specific. I'm very specific. One minute. No. You're coming back to give generalizations. I'm not going to take any generalizations. I've got Malavika Avinash on the other side in my very specific question to you. Thank you very much. This is about a system. This is about a system.
It's not just one person.
No. What? Who is talking about one person? Are you talking about one person?
No, you are talking about one person.
Are you? I'm not. I'm talking about the Bollywood mafia, Bollywood lobby. I'm asking you one question. As a question.
These people are fighting with each other.
Yes,
they want to kill each other themselves. They're all competing. They're all rivals.
No,
there is
sec,
no
wait.
Lobby.
Mayank, listen to me. Mayank, listen to me. Mayank, tell me one thing. Mayank, tell me one thing. Let's. I ask.
Mayank,
okay, Malavika. Malavika is on the debate. Malavika.
Listen to me. That's all.
Mr. Mayank, wake up and smell the coffee. Kangana has brewed it for you. Here is a guy called Mr. Soni who says she's shooting over a dead man's shoulder. And then he goes on to say that the dead man was bipolar.
One minute. The point is made by Samir. Malavika and Samir.
and absolutely deplorable things that you're saying.
Can I get your audio higher, please? One minute. Once again, Malavika says the following. Malavika, I lost you there because he was heckling you at that point of time. You were making a point to Sameer Soni. And I'd like you to repeat the point you made to Sameer Soni, Malavika. Malavika, I want you to repeat the point you made to Sameer Soni. The point you made out there. Please repeat your
point. This Mr. Soni, what does he think he is? He says, she's shooting over a dead man's shoulder. Not that he said something so deplorable. He goes on to say the dead man was bipolar. Please, sir, can you show the medical certificate? And all right, if he was indeed bipolar, were you helping him? Was the Bollywood helping him? By insulting him in public? Did you not drive him to suicide then? How dare you speak like that?
And
stop being in denial. Who are you representing? You think you're representing some saints?
Do you know
all of these guys come together and cast talent? And you're here as a spokesperson for them?
It came out to them as Dr. Percy. He's got a clinic in Bandra. Do your homework. Why isn't a doctor on the panel right now? Do your homework. Don't teach me what psychology I've suffered from my family members, okay?
Malavika!
I speak about Malavika,
Malavika! Calm down, Sameer! Malavika!
Of course, because all she said was Mahesh Bhatt threw a chappal at me. She said how Sanjay Leela Bhansali said whatever. Then all she was talking about
me.
I don't want to care about
Malavika.
I care about Sushant.
Why are you jumping? That's for Mr. Mahesh Bhatt to come out and explain. If he did throw a chappal at her or not, were you with us?
The entire interview was about Sushant. Then you've not seen it, Sameer. I tell you one thing, Sameer. Are you getting a little rattled somewhere?
Oh come on! Takes a lot more.
I hope so.
Because I have no stakes.
I hope so. I ask you this. One minute. Okay, so let me ask a very specific question. I want Vani on the debate. One minute. Vani is on the debate right now. Let Vani come on the debate with Mayank. I'll give specific examples. Chichore. It was a good grosser film. It crossed the 50 crore mark in 5 days and 100 crore mark in 12 days. I'm giving specific examples. Here I have someone who wins the Best Debut Award because she's someone's daughter. And on the other side, you have Sushant Singh Rajput, despite Chichore getting 100 crore mark in 12 days, a beautiful film, sensitive film. It's nowhere. Everyone works hard, Vani, and everyone works hard to produce quality and to produce merit and to show their merit. And we all know, and Mayank should know this.
Mayank, it takes a lot
to prove yourself and be loved in the way Sushant was.
Can I show you news reports?
I am telling you. One minute. He's saying award shows are a racket. Say it.
Yes. I'll say it all the time. I'll show your columns of mine where I've said it. How many times? Of course.
Racket run by whom?
These are all TRP-led television events.
Racket run by whom?
Racket run by various publications.
No. Racket, of which this Bollywood lobby is a part?
Of course. Because you need certain faces to be there
So they decide who becomes best movie, who becomes best debut. So they decide everything, right? They decide recognition.
Recognition is decided
excellent.
By ratings that come on television
excellent.
Shows.
Excellent. So one minute. Allow me to question you. Continue. Allow me to question you. Allow me to question you, Mayank. You have just said that a racket decides who to recognize and who to kill. Vani, he said it. He said it. Step forward. Vani.
In the film industry, it's always said that you're as good as your last Friday. And Sushant's last Friday was brilliant.
Chichori doesn't get 50 crore business in 5 days. It crossed the 200 elusive 200 crore mark on the box office. What does it tell you? The day he passed away, that whole week, the story which played out was a failure. How probably success was. I mean, when you look at the box office figures, where was the failure? Was it a failure that his career didn't take off? Was it a failure that commercially he was not a viable star? He very much was. He was more than viable on the box office. Number one. Yeah. Number two, the pretension of the film industry is we are a camaraderie. In Hindi, we say we are biradari. Hum toh biradari hai. So if we were a camaraderie and if people in the industry knew about, somebody mentioned bipolarity, I think it's a very heavy word. It cannot be taken non-seriously. If people were aware of Sushant having trouble, how many people reached out to him? How many people actually made that effort of going and speaking with him, sitting with him? We always say suicide is a 20-minute window. What does that mean? That within those 20 minutes, if somebody talks to a person who's going through that huge upheaval. And you know what the paradox is? Chichori was a sensitive film about a father who was actually battling the young son that he has who was battling depression. He tried to help him. Today, when you look back, what a paradox it is. And how heartbreaking it is that the very last film that Sushant did was very much about the whole issue that is being made out that he was depressed and that is why he committed suicide. How many people in the industry had that courage to reach out to him? Or anybody knew him. He was a very, very much loved person. He was a star who was very approachable. It wasn't that he was sitting in a white citadel, you know, somewhere with closed doors. One of the most affable people I met in my life. Those are the memories of Sushant that I have. Where did the camaraderie go? Where did the biradari pan go?
Where did that reach out? That's the point. There is no camaraderie. There is no lobby.
Don't be in denial about this. Don't be in denial. Manoj Tiwari is on the debate. Manoj Tiwari is on the debate. Savita Hiramat, 1 minute. Savita Hiramat, welcome. Savita, would you like to respond? Manoj Tiwari is a former India cricketer who wants a stronger investigation into Sushant's suicide. I'd like Savita to come in. Savita, you know, he admits all this, and at the end of the day, Savita, Mayank Shekhar says there's no lobby. I'd like you to come into the debate right now. Savita Hiramat has her own experiences debating with Akashdeep. Yeah, yes, Savita and Akashdeep, please. And then I'm coming to you, Manoj, in a bit. Ishkaran Bhandari, young lawyer, works with Subramaniam Swamy, joining us right now. This is becoming a bigger issue. First, Savita to Akashdeep. Savita.
If anyone is saying that there's no lobby, I think he's misleading the debate here totally. There is a lobby, but it's okay to have lobby, but it has to be progressive lobby. But unfortunately, here the lobby is very, very, not visionary. It's only playing politics of acting, directing, and stopping new talent to come in. Even as a producer or directors, they will just jump and buy your directors. If you have made some good films, they'll buy your talent immediately. They block them. They will not even let them progress beyond a point in the industry. And if somebody...
So you are saying success works is a wrong mantra.
Part of some lobby, I can tell you. I have done success.
What lobby are you talking about? Can I come in here, please?
Successful mantra. I know.
You are saying that if somebody's film works, everybody latches onto him and wants to sign him. That's the way success works. Who does not want a successful actor?
No, but I'm not.
What do you want us to do?
No, don't
laugh. All of
don't
you
talk.
Who are not from Bollywood just don't seem to understand
it,
the finer
can
print.
You?
Savita Raj Hiramat is a film producer. Do you Bollywood speak for yourself?
I want to be part of...
Amardeep, Savita Raj Hiramat is a recognized film producer. What are you talking about?
Okay, I have made my...
You speak for yourself.
Yes, Arnav, can I...
You speak for yourself.
I know
Savita,
what I'm talking
Savita,
about.
Savita, tell me one
okay.
thing.
I have
Savita,
made one
please
film.
Tell me one thing.
Maybe
you
I
said
have...
Bollywood was boycotting Mr. Sushant Singh Rajput.
I know how to.
How come he still did
I
a Dhoni
am
and
not.
A Chichore
this is not. I am in the business.
Okay.
I have done.
You asked her something, please, right? Let her hear. You're 1 minute, Akash.
Can
relax.
You know, stop it?
Akash, relax. You're a.
Please, can you please stop it?
Arnav,
yes,
not, Arnav
be, like,
believe
you
me, it's been an unequal representation of voices.
Okay. No, what I am saying is something else.
It is
no.
not a question of lie, loud,
No, please,
ma'am.
Let me finish
what
it.
I don't understand
let
is,
me finish
you know,
it, I said.
Out,
I don't want your mind to understand me, because you will never understand, because you're part of that game plan. Okay, so I don't want you to understand me because you understand everything, you're in denial mode. But I am saying something else. I am saying that it's good to have lobbying.
Akash, now enough, Akash. Enough, Akash. Enough, Akash. Stop it, Akash. Thank you. Thank you.
I am saying I have made a film. I had to struggle for 2 years for release also, because everybody appreciated, but then there was a lobby who stopped releasing my film also. For 2 years, I had to struggle to release my film, okay? Oh. And from pillar to post. But I was determined enough, because I was doing my other... What do you mean by... Oh, it's ridiculous to even react like that on that kind of film. I don't appreciate such kind of thing. I'm
no,
into business
for
last 30
years. No, because there is no such cabal in Bollywood that wanted to stop your
but
film.
But I've never seen...
It's now, just
please,
the newcomer struggle
now,
that you went through, probably.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Don't have these tall claims. Nobody.
Yes, so
if you are the next Francis
Ford
Coppola, welcome to
not...
Bollywood. Nobody is planning to get you out
just
of Bollywood.
Listen.
Nobody
even after
wants
that,
to keep you out of Bollywood. It's just the
after
struggle.
After that, I had to struggle for 10 years. I had to struggle for 10 years, even after releasing Khosla Ka Ghosla, to make my second film to get good talent in hand. Okay? And I know what happened after that. So you don't know. You haven't made any film, right? So don't talk to me like that.
My father has made 50 films
it's
and I have made 25 films.
And I am totally with...
Do
maybe,
your homework
but you,
before you talk.
So you're part of the game, right? So I'm not. I am not. I'm
I
not part of the game.
I know more about Bollywood than most of
okay.
this panel.
I'm not maybe... I don't want to be.
Because I have all the information from a father who
was 52
years in Bollywood.
I want to know my good content. The sad point is... The people here
are
not contributing
to
content.
Who are you
content.
To decide this
they
for Bollywood?
They are just playing games.
Every filmmaker is an individual. This is, we are not a government
why
with 520
why
MPs
not?
That each one has a role to play.
I am saying,
you are an individual.
Which,
you chose to make Khosla Ka Ghosla.
Why
I chose
Bollywood
to make Santa Banta.
Okay. Manoj Tiwari. Okay, I'm going across to Manoj Tiwari. Manoj Tiwari came into the debate. Manoj, you're a cricketer. You played for India. You are now in Bengal. You came and stepped forward. You want a deeper investigation. Tell us why.
Let me take this opportunity, Arnab, to salute Kangana Ranaut first, because the way she has come out in your interview last night, and she has spoken the truth. And that's how we all got to know what goes inside the Bollywood, how the strugglers come out to make their life and they find so difficult. And it should be an eye-opener to each and everyone. There are so many people out there who are coming out in open and telling their own stories about how difficult it is to come into Bollywood. I think it should be taken very seriously, because not everyone will come out and lies on national television and in social platforms. And I'll come straight to what I wanted to want from police department. We all have a lot of respect for our police department. 3 months back,
Manoj, can I bring you straight to the point, if you don't mind? You know, a broader point being made here, and we need to also consider why this particular issue has sparked such a debate. Having done several debates, Sameer, including some with you and everyone on right now, so see the issue is that it has sparked a debate, in my view. Because this is not restricted to Bollywood. Everyone is associating with the idea of a cabal, of a syndicate, of people who undermine merit. I think the biggest crime in this country, Manoj, of 1.3 billion people, is the fact that there is an attempt to kill merit. This is not about nepotism. Nepotism is a very mild word. It is about a crime which is then given form, and I want Ishkaran to talk about it. The crime is given form. There are evil contracts. There are evil contracts. The police should look into the evil contracts.
I hope.
They should look at movies that are put into the cold storage unceremoniously. They should talk about the institutionalized use of legal language and contracts against outsiders using this contractual power. People are talking about a potential death trap. Yes. It's serious. if today Abhinav Kashyap, who has worked on big films like Dabang and Yuva, talks about a death trap, it's about the isolation of people. The biggest crime, Ishkaran, in this country is not to kill people, absolutely, but to drive talent towards desperation. And that is why 33-year-old Kangana is today riding the waves with what she has spoken. She's spoken for millions and millions of young people in this country. I think that's the point. We are not coming into the debate yet, Ishkaran.
Go. Can I come in?
Enough for 30 seconds.
No, let us
focus on the crime. I'm not getting into lobby or nepotism. Let me just, please don't interrupt. I have just started speaking. For 30 seconds, let's focus on the crime. The fact is that on 9th July, Dr. Swami tweeted, because before that I went to him saying that there is a lot of murky things happening in this case. It requires a CBI investigation. Because very soon, without doing deep investigation, there were people coming and saying it's a suicide, let it lie down, let it not be a deep investigation. And Arnab, I was on your channels and you have done it in Sunanda Pushkar, where today we are having a bipolar theory. That time we had a lupus theory. You would remember it well.
I
some
do.
Other people from Bollywood.
It's on record,
so please,
buddy.
We can tell them what was the lupus theory bandied about. And what? Don't interrupt me. Please don't interrupt me. Sorry. I'm not taking any names. I'm not talking about you. There are other people talking about this theory. I'm not taking your name. So it is too early. What I found very strange was that a healthy young man has a mysterious death and suddenly everybody comes to a conclusion it's a suicide. What is the reason that you came to this conclusion, and what is the reason you did not call it a mysterious death which required further investigation? Second point, evil contracts in which you economically destroy a person can be abetment to suicide. And again, Arnab, I take the example of Sunanda Pushkar, where we know how the case progressed. You know it very well. I was there and I was fighting it out in courts. Third point here, Arnab, on the crime aspect of it. Only on the crime aspect I'm going on it. What we need to know very, very clearly is that I wrote a letter to the Mumbai police, two letters. One, has electronic evidence of everybody connected and incidental to them being seized or not being seized? Because there is statement on record that he changed his SIM cards 50 times. That is not ordinary behavior. All those SIM cards need to be seized. Was he running in fear of somebody? Then that is a case of abetment of suicide or murder, depending on the facts. Second point here, legal point I'm making is, was his flat seed in Sunanda Pushkar, Arnab, you know very well, the suit in which she was found dead was sealed for 3 years and 9 months. Even though the FIR was registered 1 year after her mysterious death.
No, but in that case, evidence was destroyed. No, no, one minute, just to investigate. First of all, Ishkaran, 1 minute, Ishkaran. Since this is deeply, it means a lot to me. I would not speak about the Sunanda Pushkar investigation in the past tense. I'm completely convinced that the mysterious circumstances in the killing of Sunanda Pushkar will come out. We are pursuing it. But in that case, the evidence was destroyed. That the only thing is then, one point I want to add to you. What I find very interesting about what you're saying, and viewers, the man on the left-hand side of your screen is a young emerging lawyer. His name is Ishkaran Bhandari. He works very closely with Subramaniam Swami. So he's got into all these cases. He investigates them. The interesting thing about Sunanda Pushkar's case and this one is, yes, you are right, Ishkaran. Immediately it was said this is suicide, A. B, it was said she was depressed. You remember that Malavika Ravina, she was depressed.
Yes.
She was driving herself into it. Some people invented a theory about her having a disease called lupus, which was latent proven to be untrue. So there was a very strong attempt, Malavika, if you remember, sorry to interrupt you. But immediately after, one minute, Amardeep, Akashdeep, you know nothing about the Sunanda case, so don't disturb me. You know nothing about it. We put our heart and soul into investigating it, so don't stop me.
I'm saying those...
Allow me to make my point. Allow me to make my point. Allow me to make my point. What I'm saying is, at that point of time, a powerful group in Delhi... Akashdeep, now don't infuriate me, man. Let me complete what I'm saying. At that point of time, a powerful group in Delhi immediately typecast Sunanda as a person who was depressed, Vani. A person who was going to kill herself, a person not in control of herself.
Yes.
Right? And they said it is suicide, there was fabrication of narrative, and there was destruction of evidence. The same thing is happening here. You have said Sushant is bipolar, depressed, had a problem.
I haven't.
He was driving himself up to it. We could see signals. right?
Yes.
And you've controlled the narrative. Now let's listen to the young lawyer. Ishkaran is putting other facts on the table, which honestly, I'm telling you, I'm getting feedback as you're saying.
Arnab, can I answer Ishkaran?
No, you can't answer, you got to hear him. People want to hear Ishkaran now.
Let me finish the legal aspect of it and you answer.
Arnab,
please.
Can I talk to
Ishkaran? He feels it's not suicide.
Arnab, let me answer the legal points. Two more legal points, Arnab. Arnab, I have written two letters to Mumbai police. There are some legal points I want to make on mafia, nepotism. People can speak.
Yeah, we want
I'm talking about crime here. Let me please make my legal points. Arnab, I wrote to Mumbai police saying that have you seized all the evidence in the sense of electronic, because experience in cases has shown that it sometimes doesn't happen. And there are statements on record that he used 50 SIM cards. Second point, Arnab, was the flat strictly sealed? How come in day one the flat was not strictly sealed? We have forensic evidence, we have DNA evidence. I wrote to Mumbai police and that has been widely covered by media, including Republic. Your online publication has covered it. Your team can send it to you, where I said that I am not casting any aspersions on anybody. But how are you coming to such a quick conclusion without the flat, and have you sealed the flat? And if you have not sealed the flat, why not? And I gave the example of Sunanda Pushkar in that letter to police, where, please, Arnab, you remember it very well. She died on January 14, and FIR of murder was registered in January 15, 1 year later. Still, the room was kept sealed. Has the flat been kept sealed in this case, or are we destroying DNA evidence? What is happening? These questions are on crime. They need
Why are you telling us what the police has not done? Are you saying that the Bollywood cabal or the mafia has done that? Or ensured that is done?
I'm saying people want justice.
Akash, stop it. Akash.
People want justice.
Akash, stop it. Akash, please stop it. We'll get my mind on the right, please. One second. Akash, look at the issues here.
But you need...
Look at the issues here.
Why is he reacting to this?
Look at the issues here.
Why is he reacting to
it? I understand. So question the police.
I'm saying it needs an investigation.
On all these things.
Akash, can you stop giving...
You don't question Bollywood why the flag was not sealed.
Ishkaran, complete. I don't want to stop the flow of the conversation, please, you know. Akash, have pity on me. I don't want to stop the flow of the conversation. Let him complete. Because what we are... See, there are a lot of people today who are now writing to me. And people who've lost family members. Like Ravina, you know, Neelam Katara. She's been fighting her battle. People like her are contacting us right now. They are seeing the same pattern of fabrication of evidence and fabrication of narrative. And then you blame it. And then you say, oh, he was bipolar. He was not well. He died. Too bad. If you can't stand the heat, get out of the kitchen. It's a tough life. That's not the kind of thing that which happens here. Ishkaran has placed very important things out here. Ishkaran, as a lawyer, what you're saying is giving me goosebumps, you know.
Arnab, let me just please stop interrupting. Akash, I am not saying that you did it or anybody you know did it. I'm just putting some legal points which we need justice. You should support it. You should say there should be justice in this case. Manoj has tweeted about justice in this case. Please let us talk on the legal points. I'm not blaming you. Aap kyun jump maar rahe ho? Fact herein is that was the flat strictly sealed or not? Arnab, you know what happened in Sunanda Pushkar, how theories of lupus came about. And those who do not know, it was said that she was in depression because she had such serious ailments that she popped herself off. And later on, we have a chart sheet also now. And I was in court in that, and Arnab, you were doing it daily on TV.
Yeah.
So we know what happened.
I've still not given it up.
I'm saying that theories and narratives which are getting built up within days, within hours of a mysterious death are shocking. And that is why I started examining it legally and based on documents. Who knows it was abetment to suicide? Who knows it was murder? Who knows it was maybe a tragedy? But that needs an independent investigation, and there are Supreme Court judgments on this.
But this aspect about him changing his SIM cards. This aspect about him changing his SIM cards. Can you please tell everyone watching this, where is that evidence come from that he changed his SIM cards hundreds of times? And where did you get that?
Just Google it. It's a statement made by one people from a person from Bollywood. One second. I'll just Google it and tell you. 50 SIM. So Chand Singh Rajput. Shekhar Suman. Shekhar Suman, who's from Bollywood, made a statement that Sushant Singh Rajput changed his SIM cards 50 times in a month. Has he been questioned? He's been asking for justice. That's not an ordinary course. You change your SIM card once. It's a pain nowadays to give your number to other people.
True.
5 times, 50 times. What is happening? Don't these questions need a deep dive into it?
Yeah.
I'm only saying this needs a deep dive. This needs a thorough investigation as to what was happening. Why are we all going with the presumption of suicide? Because some people said it's suicide. So it's a side.
They're calling it murder.
We need a thorough investigation.
No, my concern is that is the Mumbai police doing reverse engineering out here? Where it's already decided the reasons and the circumstances, it's only going through the motions to give an impression that there is some kind of an investigation going on out here.
Arnab, also this going through the motions, I raised a very simple point. You can send your team in Mumbai.
There is a death threat given to me.
Audience wants to know
by this mafia, which is available on my Twitter account.
Why is this person jumping on investigation?
Yeah.
Why are you jumping and interfering on investigation demand? What is it to you?
Yeah.
I don't understand.
Yeah.
It's a demand for investigation, and you are jumping on that also.
Yeah.
What is the reason?
I think one factor.
You have journalists there.
Yeah.
Please send some journalists to know, was the flat sealed on June 14th or not? Mumbai police doesn't suffer anything by making a public statement. Public confidence is integral to law and order. I have so many people telling me that the flat wasn't sealed. I can't verify it. I'm in Delhi. Please send a journalist to know, was the flat sealed on 14 June for forensics, for DNA, or was it not sealed? Was it a public park? Anybody could come in and destroy any evidence. That's a basic factual question.
Yeah.
We need an answer to facts at least.
Yeah.
Don't we deserve an answer on facts?
And I think underlying the points being made here, I go back to Naveena and Mayank here, we need to understand, this is an industry, there are money involved, there are interests involved. The emergence of new studios, new production houses, new talent that is not subservient to you can disrupt the system. And therefore, there is money involved. There are brands involved. There are contracts involved, right? Raveena, you know the media industry well.
Yeah. I do. Arnab, I think it's very important that this investigation reveals the kind of processes and the kind of negotiations that determine who wins and who loses in this game. You know, it's an unfair practice. It's hugely questionable. Okay. You know, the fact that Kangana was dropped from 19 brands overnight, that decision was made by somebody who was told by somebody who's controlled by somebody for another reason. And these are very important processes for them to investigate if you really want to get to the bottom of how the industry works. It is not only by whim, it is by design. And in this case, if there has been no investigation properly done in the death of Sushant Singh Rajput, who had actually, you know, moved from being the second citizen of Bollywood as a TV star into becoming a first citizen almost in the movie industry, then what happened that made somebody either drive him to suicide or bump him off? I mean, we need to know this, don't we? Because the system is rotten. Like most other systems that are rotten need to be investigated. And it's always the money. Follow the money.
Yeah.
This needs to be investigated.
What if this is Sameer and Vani? What if this is not about a suicide case? As you know, what if Sameer, you believe this narrative? You say you know that he killed himself, bipolar.
This is a problem
that you don't listen. You see, the thing here is, Sushant and Kangana are roughly the same age. Okay, let me put a few facts before you.
Okay.
Sushant and Kangana are roughly the same age.
Mm-hmm.
They match each other in terms of raw talent, right, Vani?
Right.
Raw talent. Let's look at them. Both come from humble backgrounds.
Correct.
Both have battled it out in a big way. And both are being constantly told by the same group of people, oh, you're mad, you're psychotic, please don't kill yourself. Kangana said, Vani, yesterday that people are coming and telling her, please don't kill yourself. She called them the dark group, the suicide gang. The difference is she fought back and maybe here he gave in. But at the core of it, you are surrounded by media, contracts, lawyers, studios, money, international groups. So there's a lot at stake. What if this is a bigger battle? That if you have a Kangana and a Sushant really break through and they're not in your grasp, what if tomorrow they upset the business interests, Vani?
No, of course.
Right?
It's almost like a designed situation.
Everything is fabricated, everything is designed. That's why when I said the PR and the marketing machinery, even besides the clothes you wear, the way you speak, and anything which comes out of the normal and the obvious, and the normal is always decided by this whole, sort of machinery which works around. Let me also tell you, even people who come from a drama and a theatre background, who come from drama schools very much like me, when you come into the industry, it takes you a really long time to even figure out how mechanized this whole process is. And obviously, it upsets a lot of flutters, a lot of feathers, if you do not fit into the puzzle exactly the way the puzzle is supposed to be, the kind of design it is. And obviously, with a lot of actors who are very talented, that's why I'm saying the last decade has been so revealing in terms of its narrative. There have been so many given already. If a woman is a protagonist, the film will not get produced, it will not get released. The whole machinery of the exhibition and the distributed nexus. Why are we only talking about one nexus? There are so many various kinds of nexuses which actually operate in the film industry. A producer and a director struggles for months and years to get a film even to the theatres. I mean, one of the largest film producing nations of the world has only 1,700 exhibition capacities in the country. Isn't that so much of a dense situation? But I will say that if this becomes a debate, to push that door open, and I'm saying the glass ceiling is, all the time we used to say glass ceiling is for women and for actresses and, how they are. There's a huge glass ceiling which is for people who are talented and who do not belong to, as I say, the high and mighty dynasts of the industry. Let this debate kick in. Let us kick open every single door. We are a democracy, damn it.
Akash.
Let this be a democratic debate.
Yeah.
People who dissent, who do not agree, fine. But at least this part of the Indian film industry, I'm again reiterating, Bollywood is a terrible cheap term. Let this part of the industry come out. Let there be a nationwide debate. Let people who also consume...
There already is one. Manoj wants to come in here. Manoj wants to add in something. I cut him short the last time, so I'm extending by a minute. Manoj.
Arnab, I think it's all interrelated. And I will come very specific to what... Krishnji has... You want to know about this case. There are so many videos coming out in social media. We want to believe in police department. We appreciate their work which they have done for COVID on the field. But at the same time, you want to win the faith of...
Lost the audio again.
People are asking. I was saying that to gain the faith of the people...
Yeah. I'm so sorry. I'll get you again next time because I'm losing the audio. I'm really short of time. I want to say two things. I hope you agree with me at the end. We agree there is a huge problem.
Arnab, can I say something?
Was Savita? Yeah, go on, Savita. Yeah, go on.
Yeah. I was saying that, it's just that, fortunately, we are just talking about, at this point of time, actors where people have major interest, but people behind the scene, even directors, writers, even they are getting, what kind of life, the new talent is not getting good life, good welcome there. And there are also many suicides, killings, many things are happening. We need to see in totality and how everywhere is getting pushed back.
Okay, I think the first and most important thing is that we should not be in denial. The second thing is, I think we need to crack open the dark reality of Bollywood. The third thing is, please... this is a fact. People were in denial about the role of the underworld in Bollywood as well. We know the 80s and the 90s, people were in denial about the role of the underworld in Bollywood. It came to light. It was there.